Quadratic inequalities. Quadratic inequality. What is quadratic inequality? As with linear inequality, quadratic inequality is a univariate inequality. It can be written in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c greater than 0, ax squared plus bx plus c less than 0, ax squared plus bx plus c greater than or equal to 0, or ax squared plus bx plus c less than or equal to 0. Anatomy of quadratic inequality in standard form. Ax squared plus bx plus c, this one is quadratic expression, and greater than is unequal sign 0. So quadratic term is ax squared, and linear term bx, and this c is the free term. So actually a here, quadratic coefficient for all real number, but a cannot be 0, and b linear coefficient for all real number, and c here constant for all real number. Solving quadratic inequalities, there are two methods to solve quadratic inequalities. First one is algebraic method, second one is graphical method. Okay, for algebraic method, you can use table of sign or using real number line. Signs of quadratic expression. Suppose we have quadratic expression negative 3x squared plus 7x minus 2. This one is just for example. Factoring the expression equal to 3x minus 1 multiply 2 minus x. The zeros of negative 3x squared plus 7x minus 2 are 1 over 3 and 2. So whenever the value of x is between 1 over 3 and 2, the expression evaluates to a positive value. Whenever the value of x is either less than 1 over 3 or greater than 2, the expression negative 3x squared plus 7x minus 2 evaluates to a negative value. So you can illustrate in the following table of signs. So the interval negative infinity to 1 over 3, you can substitute any value that less than 1 over 3. For example, 1 over 3 here is actually 0.333. Okay, so the value less than 0.33, for example, you can take 0.2. So you substitute into this interval, you will get negative value. Okay, and then you try substitute any value between 1 over 3 to 2, for example 1, substitute into this interval, you will get positive answer. So here positive sign. And for interval 2 greater than infinity, for example 3, substitute into the interval, you will get negative answer. So negative sign. We can also see negative 3x squared plus 7x minus 2 as a product of 3x minus 1 and 2 minus x. 3x minus 1 is positive when x is greater than 1 over 3, negative when x is less than 1 over 3. 2 minus x is positive when x is less than 2, negative when x is greater than 2. Sign of product is then positive when both 3x minus 1 and 2 minus x are the same sign, or negative when they are not. We can illustrate the previous idea in single table of sign. Interval negative infinity to 1 over 3, 1 over 3 to 2, 2 to infinity. So the product of negative 3x squared plus 7x minus 2, okay, this one is the product. Okay, and then you substitute the value in the interval here into each of the product, then you get negative sign, positive, 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 negative. Okay, so here 3x minus 1 multiply 2 minus x, negative multiply positive, you will get negative sign. Positive multiply positive, you get positive. And positive multiply negative, you will get negative. I will explain further in next example, example 11. Steps to solving using table of sign. First step, write inequality in standard form. Second, reduce or factor the algebraic expression. Number 3, determine zeros of the algebraic expression. Construct table of sign. Take intervals with relevant signs as solution. Include zeros of the expression in solution as required. Let's try example 11. Solve the inequality of 2x squared minus x less than 3. First step, you need to rearrange this inequality into standard form. 2x squared minus x minus 3 less than 0. Next step, factorize x plus 1 multiply 2x minus 3 less than 0. And next step, find the zeros. X plus 1 equal to 0, so your x will be negative 1. And then another one, 2x minus 3 equal to 0, 2x equal to positive 3, x equal to 3 over 2. The zeros of 2x squared minus x minus 3 are negative 1 and 3 over 2. Next steps, the table of signs of 2x squared minus x minus 3 then becomes, you write the interval, so our zeros is negative 1 and 3 over 2. So the interval start from negative infinity to negative 1, followed by negative 1 to 3 over 2, and 3 over 2 to positive infinity. So we have 3 intervals based on the zeros that you get previously. The product of x plus 1, choose any value that less than negative 1 and substitute into the product x plus 1. You can choose negative 2 here. Negative 2 plus 1 equal to negative 1, so negative sign. And then next interval, negative 1 to 3 over 2. Here you can choose 0. 0 is between negative 1 and 3 over 2. 0 plus 1 equal to 1, so positive answer. And then here you can choose any number that greater than 3 over 2, for example number 4. So 4 plus 1 equal to 5, so positive answer, positive sign here. Next product is 2x minus 3. So 2x minus 3, substitute any value that less than negative 1 into 2x plus 3. Substitute negative 2 into 2x minus 3. 2 times negative 2 minus 3 equal to negative 7, so negative sign. And then 0 times 2 minus 3, negative 3, so negative sign here. And then 2 times 4 minus 3 equal to 5, positive sign here. X plus 1 multiply 2x minus 3, the product, negative multiply negative, you will get positive. And then positive multiply negative, you will get negative here. Positive multiply positive, you will get positive here. 2x squared minus x minus 3 less than 0 requires that 2x squared minus x minus 3 to be less than 0. Therefore, the interval at which the expression evaluates to negative value is the solution. Therefore, the solution of 2x squared minus x less than 3 is negative 1 to 3 over 2. So, based on the table of signs, the negative signs is located at interval negative 1 to 3 over 2. Therefore, the solution is negative 1, 3 over 2.